SpaceX had to cancel a launch attempt 3 hours earlier because of strong winds in the upper atmosphere. At 22:14 EDT, the Falcon 9 took off from NASA's Kennedy Space Center Launch Complex 39A with 52 more missiles as part of the 54th dedicated Falcon 9 mission for the Internet constellation in low Earth orbit. SpaceX has successfully launched its 3000th Starlink satellite. Want to know more about it? Then stay tuned till the end of the video. The 3000th Starlink satellite was successfully launched by SpaceX as part of the 54th dedicated Falcon 9 mission for the Internet constellation in low Earth orbit, 3 hours after SpaceX was forced to abort a launch attempt due to strong upper-level winds. The Falcon 9 successfully launched from NASA's Kennedy Space Center Launch Complex 39A at 22:14 EDT, carrying an additional 52 new missiles. Inside of a rocket payload fairing that has been tested in flight are Starlink V1.5 satellites. The Falcon 9 booster that was assigned to SpaceX for the mission also flew for the third time. Like the fairing halves, both of which have already supported two orbital-class launches, the booster was also used for the mission. The majority of the time, the Falcon 9 performed its operations as expected. The booster carried the expendable upper stage and the enclosed payload through a significant portion of the journey beyond the atmosphere of Earth before breaking apart and returning to the planet. The upper stage of the Falcon 9 rocket performed as flawlessly as it ever has, successfully delivering the Starlink stack into a parking orbit that was both low and elliptical. Once there, the rocket eventually spun around and released all 52 satellites at the same time. Late on Tuesday evening, a Falcon 9 rocket that had already been used 3 times lifted off from the historic Pad 39A at the Kennedy Space Center in Florida. The rocket was carrying dozens of additional Starlink Internet communication satellites that were intended to be placed into low Earth orbit. The B-1073 core, which had previously flown 2 missions in the middle of May and at the end of June, before being added to the Falcon 9 fleet earlier this year, lifted off for the first time at 10:14 p.m. EDT, following a delay of 3.5 hours caused by upper-level winds. With the completion of its second flight of the month of August, SpaceX has now successfully placed more than 3,000 Starlinks of production design into orbit in a little over 3 years. About 9 minutes after liftoff, the Falcon 9 booster B-1073 successfully navigated entry and landing without experiencing any issues, and it made a safe landing on the unmanned craft known as the A Shortfall of Gravitas. Although this landing was ultimately successful, the B-1073's accuracy was not entirely flawless, and the booster stalled when 2 of its 4 legs were unusually close to the edge of the drone ship's deck. Despite this, the landing was still successful. If the booster had missed the target by just 5 to 10 feet, it could have easily landed just 1 or 2 feet from the deck and caused the ship to capsize, sending it and its passengers into the Atlantic Ocean. Despite this, SpaceX reports that the landing was a success, and the company anticipates that the recovery of the booster will proceed without incident. Because Starlink's flawless launches and nearly spot-on landings have become such a common occurrence that any deviation from this norm has become interesting, it would hardly be worth noticing in any other context. However, because Starlink's launches and landings have become so frequent and routine, any deviation from this norm has become interesting. It was SpaceX's 54th dedicated Starlink launch overall, and it was Starlink's 21st launch in 2022 by itself. Starlink 426 refers to the 26th batch of group or Shell 4 satellites, a milestone so far ahead of the next largest satellite constellation that it is now more reasonable to compare Starlink to any other satellite that is currently in orbit was also accomplished by SpaceX during this mission. The 3000th Starlink satellite was launched as part of the mission. Since 2018, SpaceX has successfully launched 3,009 Starlink satellites into orbit. However, only 2,750 of those satellites are still operational. Jonathan McDowell, an astrophysicist and space object tracker, estimates that SpaceX currently has 2,714 operational satellites in orbit. This number is based on the assumption that all 52 Starlink 426 satellites are functional. 92.3% of all operational Starlink satellites launched by SpaceX since November of 2019 are still in orbit, This excludes 75 prototype satellites that were launched over the years, of which all but five have since deorbited. Even though the Starlink V1.0 satellite failure rate of 7.7% is not at all desirable, SpaceX has made significant headway with its V1.5 design, which will begin launch operations in September of 2021. With the exception of 38 satellites that were destroyed when an intense solar storm caused an expansion in the atmosphere of the Earth because of an unanticipated increase in drag to an uncontrollable level, only 10 of the 1,218 Starlink V1.5 satellites that were launched by SpaceX failed and re-entered the atmosphere prematurely due to technical issues. This represents a failure rate of 0.9%. If SpaceX V1.5 satellites continue to demonstrate superior reliability as they reach an age comparable to that of their V1.0 forebears, this will bode well for the sustainability and predictability of both the existing Starlink constellation as well as any constellations that may be developed in the future. In the meantime, the approximately 2,270 Starlink satellites that are currently operational are continuing to deliver internet services to hundreds of thousands of customers in countries all over the world, thereby making the lives of countless individuals better. According to Next Spaceflight, SpaceX is planning up to 5 more launches of its Starlink satellite constellation this month. This comes as the company continues to steadily follow the record launch frequency of its Falcon 9 rocket. After that, the launch of Starlink 3-3 from California could take place as soon as August the 12th. Ben Cooper, a photographer, has received word that a second Starlink mission on the East Coast is getting ready to launch in the very near future. The most recent launch marked the 35th mission for the Falcon 9 rocket in just this year alone. As a result, the Falcon 9 is a rocket that puts in the most work. As SpaceX continues to expand its satellite mega constellation, the majority of these missions have consisted of delivering additional Starlink satellites to orbit. The staggeringly large fleet of satellites that are all linked together can now provide internet connectivity to virtually every part of the globe. Elon Musk, the founder and CEO of SpaceX, has ambitious plans to launch a staggering total of 42,000 satellites into Earth orbit. These satellites will provide connectivity to users on land, in the air, and at sea. The FCC has granted launch authorization for 12,000 Starlinks as of yet, with approval for the remaining 30,000 Starlinks still pending. According to the statistics that were compiled by astrophysicist Jonathan McDowell, a total of 2,957 Starlink satellites had already been launched into space to the launch that took place yesterday, of which 2,698 satellites are currently in orbit, and 2,662 satellites are currently operational. Because SpaceX is both a rocket company and a satellite company, it has a significant advantage over its rivals when it comes to launching internet satellites into space. This success can be attributed in large part to the fact that SpaceX is a hybrid business that combines the two industries. OneWeb, which is in direct competition with SpaceX in this sector, has even asked SpaceX for assistance in putting its satellites into orbit, so that they can form a much more manageable internet constellation that consists of 648 satellites. In addition, Amazon is making preparations to launch a constellation consisting of 3,236 satellites for its Project Kuiper. The launch of the company's satellites was recently scheduled to take place on board rockets. From Ariane Space, Blue Origin, and United Launch Alliance. However, the company did not include space in this group of launch providers. Astronomers are becoming increasingly concerned that new internet satellites will continue to interfere with their ability to observe the cosmos, as these companies work feverishly to build out their artificial constellations across the skies. Even though SpaceX has made some efforts in the past to reduce the brightness of its satellites, the company plans to launch larger and brighter satellites in the near future. So the outlook for future views of the night sky is not good. So that's all for today's video. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, and if you want to watch more videos like this one, hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so that you will always be notified.